Friends and hello student, my name is Ashok Sijala. In this session we learn the write and read integer value in file in C language. So file management in C. So let us start. I share my laptop screen and here fix the position of my screen so you can watch better way my video lecture. And here Turbo C++, I double click and take some process, and now yes, is open. Alt F file menu and taking new file. And here our goal, write a program to write and read integer values in a text file. Yes, so in previous, there are four video lecture I take in file management in C language. So first only read, and then read and write using get C and put C function, and then also read and write two video lecture as a F get C and F put C. So that is a pair of, and here we can use the two function and that syntax integer that is written and then put W. Yes, and here you can pass the integer variable X like and file. Our file is a defined data type, yes, and that stream is collection of bytes. Yes, that is a syntax of, you can write one integer value in the file, and like in get C is a get C and put C. So put C is a write one character value, here write one integer value, that is a difference. And then get W, that is a reading from the file, and that write put W write from into file. So here again define, and then string, that is syntax of these two function. So these two function we can use in this session. Yes, that is a syntax. So yes, that is I just reference for your, and here you can also refer in the help library. So Alt H, yes, and we can say that get W. So get W and put W. So get W gets an integer from the string, means reading from the file, and put W puts an integer on to a file, on a stream, means file. Stream means collection of bytes. And here, yes, that is a, here syntax is already provided. So get W file stream and put W post integer, and that file stream we have to pass, and that header file is a std, so we cannot put any extra, that standard input output or library. So yes, so we can start. Yes, so very simple. So here we can write and read directly both operation in one file. First we can write one file integer type and then read. Okay, so stdio.h. so, and then second, our header file conio console input output, and then void main. Yes, and then we can start the writing, but first we can declare one integer x variable and I for for loop. So we can write the five or something that any number of times you can require. So here we can five integer value write into file and read, and yes, that is defined data type and clear screen. So that is two integer variable, and previously I can take ch as a character and file string pointer. So here is a defined data type file management. So write and read in integer value. So here first we can open. Yes, fp is a open. So f open function is there, and there are two arguments. So first I my video lecture, you can also syntax of f open and f close function. I can also give the how many tasks and what is that syntax, all that. If you not watch that video, I recommendation to you to watch, so you can better understand in this video lecture. So here we can give the path. Yes, so file name with path, that syntax. So here our default in this editor, here chain directory, we can not listed our drive. So look, in second editor is that my laptop also, but that not full screen, so I can use this editor. But here we can use this default Turbo C3 and bin folder. So yes, turbo C 3 and double slash bin directory. Okay, and then we can give the file name. So here we can say that integer, yes, integer file. So we can say that integer temp.txt, okay, temporary. And then second argument mode, write for W for write mode, and R for read mode, and A for append. W plus, R plus, and A plus, there are six type of mode in text file and six type of mode in the binary file. So there are two types of filing. First, we can learn the text file. Next, step by step, we can also see the binary file also. Okay, so file, yes, that is perfect. And let us check our path is perfect also. Here we can compare our path, yes. So here we can put and check, yes. So any not spelling mistake, T-U-R-B-O-C-3 and bin, yes, that perfectly. So now I close this. And now we can write some, give the message first. So here, enter 5 integer values. Yes. So here we can declare only one integer, like 1D array. We can start our for loop. So I less than or equal to 5 because I start with 1. And we can write here. Yes. So write. Yes. Here we can write, and that is a first we can scanf function. So yes, here percentage d and ampersand x, yes, that and put w. So that is a put means first we can pass x and then fp file pointer. So that is a write, yes, and that for loop is a 5 time repetition, and same one variable we can scan x. You can also take 1D array and that index. Okay, and then here we can close, yes, close, F close function is there, and pass file pointer. So that complete, and also we can verify here one if condition, if the file pointer is assigned to null. So that means that our path is some mistake, wrong, or spelling mistake, that any folder mistake, is that here path syntax mistake, double slash, you can provide single slash, that type of. So here we can give one message. So file can't open. Okay, that type of message. And here there are two possibility. Either you can return, yes, return keyword, or exit, yes. But before exit, you can close the file. Yes, here we can also close file pointer. And here we can use, in previous my video lecture, I use the return keyword. Here I exit. So exit is a function inbuilt, and that header file is required. Yes, that is a process.h header file is there. So in menu driven, we can use the exit function. So yes, that writing is perfectly. So now let us take, I first only write and then read. So let us first I save this file. So we can say that write and read and integer value. So int value, yes, but maximum we can provide the 8 characters. So here is a more. So here dot c, yes, that already I replace and compile. Yes, there is no any error. Our exe file is generated. So I just first write and not read. So first we can write and then read. So first let us check that file is created or not. So if w mod that file exits, so that is all content deleted and then new content write, and not file is exit, so that is created. So that is a txt notepad we can open. So yes, let us check. I control F9, run this program. So yes, enter 5 integer value. So here like a one dimensional array, we can give 5 value. So that message, yes, that completely no any error, yes. And let us check. I press window key and go in our C drive, because that is stored in C drive. So here is a C drive. And turbo C++ and Dix that directly take in this folder, turbo C3 and bin folder. So we can only turbo C3 and bin that take automatically Dix folder. And here our int, yes, I press. So here you can look our notepad file is created. And let us check open. So that is a not a readable format. because that is an integer data type. So in symbolic, that right. So yes, that is created perfectly. And how to read this file? So yes, let us check. We can read also to editor or open full screen, and let us like copy this all code here to start to this part and close and copy and paste. So we can read that file. Yes, that file is created, but we cannot directly read in the notepad means. So here read mode, yes, here I change the path is same. And that is also same condition is not changed. So I copy this whole code and not enter. Here you cannot say the enter, but file details are, okay, not integer, you can also give. So file details are and slash n. And here you can also provide like slash n, so that next line. And then here we cannot take for loop because we have to already write while loop we have to take. And then our x variable itself we have to use. And that also parentheses and get w, yes, that is and file pointer pass and not equal to EOF end of file. So every file terminate with EOF end of file, and that ASCII code is 26, that ASCII code. And here we can print, yes, that only one line, so brace is not required. Yes, I remove the brace and we can take the while loop. So here we can change the printf, not yes, printf percentage e, yes, and that x value. And you can separate, yes, slash t or slash n, yes, here we slash t. And yes, here parentheses and here I complete. So that not equal to null. So whenever null is appear, that condition is false and that is close file. So that one by one, that integer value is reading. So let us take, yes, I compile, there is no any error. So yes, all are well. So let us check, I run. So yes, enter file integer value. So I give sequence, you can give any value, but I give 1 to 5. Yes, and that reading, yes. So file details are five integer value that read. So yes, here we cannot, yes, here get ch. So I can alter F5 function key. So you can also watch your output. So get ch, here I can now, and here we can write some different. So I give randomly value, not sequence. So that possibility, no error. So yes, 2 is there. So 8, 9, 9 is not. So yes, let us check. So file detail r. So here you can write any number of integer value. So here I give the file. Yes, here static, but you can scan from user n value and then control to yourself. So that is possibility. And let us check. So here I take one n variable, and here we can take n. So how many number you can not fix here? Yes, here we cannot fix n number of value, n integer value, n for we can pass to runtime. So that is possibility. So here we can scan first n. Yes, so here we can take, so that loop is control to ourselves. So here enter number of values. Yes, how many number can enter. So scanf and we can percentage d and m percent n. So that is loop control over there. And here is a while loop, so there is no need. So that is a, now let us like 1d array. So here I write only 3 values. So yes, n value, so n is a 3. And yes, so 1, 2, and 3, that is read. And I give any number of, like I give 10 values. So that is a loop is 10 type repetition. So you can give, yes, any number of, and 2 digit is also, there is no problem. So now I give 2 digit number. Yes, so all are perfectly write and read. So that is our file, how to write integer value in write and first write and read. Yes, so that is an. Let us check our exit function work perfectly. So here I by mistakenly give one slash remove. So we can take one error, how that error is coming. So let us take, I compile and run. So that is a bypass exit. So how we can see that message, file can't open. So Alt F5, yes, you can look, file can't open, cannot be open means. So which key I press? Alt F5 function key. So you can see your output and which menu that all these shortcut key. So Alt W and here user screen, that is Alt F5, that is you can see your screen. Okay, so that option I can use. And yes, now I correct the path. So here I by mistakenly 1/remove. So that now path is correct. And now again, that perfectly work. So now I write again 5 integer. So not sequence, give randomly. So yes, that is very easy. So yes, 5 integer value, write and read. So we can take both. And so very important, these two very simple, put W and get W, two integer value. So get C, put C, F get C, put C is a character by character reading and writing. And here we can integer value, write and reading. So that is a different pair. Yes, so now I complete, yes, very simple. And we can check also exit here, writing time and also reading time. If you, here you can mistake. So that is also taking, like I, by mistake give the not any that file, I less some text, so that not found file. So let us check, I run that is happening or not. So here we can give like 3, 1, 2, 3, but that directly exit. So how? So file can't open. So first we can write time can't not open, give the error and take the message. And now we can reading time, give the mistake, giving the file name. So any mistake of writing of path mistake means syntax mistake, \ is compulsory, or in the file name, so that not perfectly write and read. So now I perfectly give the file name and let us take run again. So now I give 3 sample, 1, 2, 3, yes, that perfectly write and read. So any number of here taking array, here not taking array, here we can by default, that is array type work because we have to not require one time. So you can also take 1D array, there is no problem. So yes, all are well. So now I close this session. So here we can learn the put W and get W, write integer value and read integer value in file management in C language. And that is a text file. Okay, so that text file we can write and read. In binary file, we can use the f write and f read function is there. So here, and what is benefit? Exactly our data type bytes that store, and text file is a character integer, and that is number, and that means symbol that is writable. And binary file only writes in bytes. So like our source file, that is a text file, and that exe file is a executable object, or that file is a bytes file. So that type of, so let us in next upcoming, I can step by step, we can go. So yes, write this program to your C notebooks. If you prepare very interesting and very simple session in this lecture or video lecture in my YouTube channel. So yes, I close this file. So yes, write this program to your C notebook. Okay, and Alt F3, I close this file and Alt X quit. So subscribe my channel Ashok Sehgal Academy, press the bell icon to never miss any update. Thanks for your watching, supporting and sharing my video lecture. And any doubt for file management of C language or any concept in C language, you can write in comment section. I can definitely give to answer. And also you can send the message in my WhatsApp number 8140154318, Ashok Sehgal. That is, you can send some message and your reference, which college and what it is your name. So I can send to your solution, any doubt of any definition to your C, C++, Java, C#, ASP.NET project for your BCA 5 and 6M. So yes, J2EE, so all I 14 year I experience in teaching field. So I almost all language teaching to my students, so my college. So yes, I complete. Thanks again and Hare Krishna.